Hello dear friends, today the topic of the class is characteristics of op-amp. What op-amp stands for? Operational amplifier. So in this class you will be understanding what are the different characteristics, what are their symbolic notations, equations and how to define them. So let us start with the first characteristics, input offset voltage, symbolically written as VIO. Input offset voltage is the voltage that must be applied between the two input terminals of an op-amp to null the output. So when it can happen generally? What can be the common voltage to the two input terminals? It can be noise voltage. So characteristics telling is the voltage that must be applied between the two input terminals of an op-amp to null the output. The voltage that must be applied between the two input terminals of an op-amp to null the output. Coming to the next characteristics, input offset current, IIO, is the algebraic difference between the currents into the inverting and non-inverting terminal. What it is the algebraic difference of IB1 minus IB2. What is IB1? Current into non-inverting input. IB2 is the current into the inverting input. Input offset current is the algebraic difference between the currents into the inverting and non-inverting terminals of the op-amp. Next characteristics is input bias current. Input bias current is symbolically written as IB, is the average of the currents that flow into the inverting and non-inverting terminals of the op-amp. IB is equal to IB1 plus IB2 by 2. Input offset current is the algebraic difference of the currents at inverting and non-inverting. Algebraic difference of the currents that flows into non-inverting and inverting. And input bias current is the average of the currents at non-inverting and inverting terminals of the op-amp. Next characteristics is input resistance, RI, which is also known as differential input resistance. Differential input resistance is the equivalent resistance that can be measured either at inverting or non-inverting terminal with other terminal connected to ground. So in this we have seen input offset voltage VIO, input offset current IIO, input bias current IB, input resistance RI. In my next slide, I will be further discussing about other few characteristics of op-amp. So next characteristics is large signal voltage gain, capital A. What is gain? Output by input. So what is the output voltage symbolically written as V0? What is input voltage to the op-amp? Differential input, VID. So capital A is written as V0 by VID. Next characteristics is output resistance, R0. R0 is a equivalent resistance that can be measured between the output terminal of the op-amp and the ground. Equivalent resistance that can be measured between the output terminal of the op-amp and the ground. Next important characteristics of op-amp is common mode rejection ratio, CMRR. It is defined as ratio of differential voltage gain to common mode voltage gain. Differential gain by common mode gain is known as CMRR. What is differential gain, which is also known as large signal gain, A, is equal to V0 by VID, output voltage by differential input voltage. ACM, common mode voltage gain, output common mode voltage gain by the input common mode voltage gain. So what is common mode voltage gain? Output common mode voltage by input common mode voltage. So here in this diagram you can see what is VCM, the common mode voltage, input voltage. By this input voltage, the output obtained will be written as VOCM. So for this VCM, what will be the output? VOCM. So what is ACM now? VOCM by VCM. VOCM is the output common mode voltage. VCM is the input common mode voltage. ACM is common mode voltage gain. What is CMRR? Common mode rejection ratio, which is equal to AD by ACM, differential gain by common mode gain. It's a very important parameter. Slew rate. Next characteristics is slew rate. Slew rate is defined as maximum rate of change of output voltage per unit time. Symbolically, it is written as VR, SR. SR is equal to dV0 by dt. Maximum rate of change of output voltage per unit time. What is the unit of output voltage? Volts. Per unit time change in microsecond. So its unit is volts per microsecond. Next characteristics is gain bandwidth product. What is bandwidth? The range of frequencies which every signal will have its frequency. How many signals of different frequencies can be passed through the device? So we can say bandwidth is range of frequencies. What is gain bandwidth product? GB is the bandwidth of the op amp when the voltage gain is 1. Bandwidth of the op amp when voltage gain is 1. So in this slide we have seen the important characteristics as large voltage gain capital A, output resistance R0, CMRR, slew rate, gain bandwidth product. In the next slide we'll be seeing what are the characteristics of an ideal op amp. So after defining all the characteristics of the op amp, now you will be easily able to know how to know what are their notations. So here, after the definitions of characteristics of op amp, next topic is characteristics of ideal op amp. The first point is infinite voltage gain. Infinite voltage gain. A symbol is A. Infinite, A is infinity. Why it is A is infinity? What is A? Output voltage by input voltage. So A is infinity means output voltage is a very large value. It means the gain is very large. Ideally, how much it is? Infinity. Input resistance is infinite input resistance, so that any signal source can drive it and there is no loading of the preceding stage. Ri is how much? Input resistance is how much? Infinity. Third point is zero output resistance, R0. Zero output resistance, so that output can drive an infinite number of other devices. R0 is zero. Fourth point is zero output voltage when the input voltage is zero. So when the input voltage is zero, what should be the ideal output voltage? Zero. Infinite bandwidth, so that any frequency signal from 0 to infinite hertz can be amplified without attenuation. bandwidth is infinity. So what will happen? Any signal of any frequency can be passed through the op amp without attenuation. Infinite common mode rejection ratio, CMRR, is how much? Infinity. What is CMRR? AD by ACM. So AD is what? Differential gain by common mode gain. So ACM is how much? Zero. So common mode gain is zero, or so what happens? CMRR is infinity. Infinite common mode rejection ratio, so that common mode noise voltage is zero. Infinite slew rate, so that output voltage changes occur simultaneously with input voltage changes. So whenever there is change in input voltage, some appropriate change must occur in the output voltage. Simultaneously both the changes are occurring. If there is any change at input, simultaneously there will be change in output voltage. So here these are the 7 important characteristics of the op amp. So here if you observe, gain is infinity, RI is infinity, R0 is only 0, bandwidth is infinity, CMRR is infinity, slew rate is infinity. So here in this 6 parameters, 7 parameters, the definitions and values of ideal op amp is clear, I hope. So here I have summarized a table for the characteristics comparing ideal op amp and practical op amp. For the practical op amp, I have taken an example of 741C op amp. So what is ideal op amp gain? Infinity. Input resistance? Infinity. Output resistance? Zero. Bandwidth is zero. Bandwidth is infinity. CMRR? Infinity. Slew rate is infinity. So if you look at this 6 characteristics, all are infinity except R0. R0 is zero. So it's easy to remember also for the students. So in this 6 characteristics, only R0 is 0 and remaining all are infinite. Coming to practical op amp, capital A value is around 2 lakhs. Input resistance is 2 mega ohms. Mega means how much? 10 to the power 6 ohms. R0 is a very small value, 75 ohms. Input is 2 mega and output is 75 ohms. Bandwidth is 1 megahertz. CMRR is 90 dB. What is this dB? Decibels. So why you want to convert a value into decibels? So that we can easily plot the value, very small value or a very large value, in a decibel scale. How do we convert a value into decibels? 20 log of the given value. What's the slew rate? It's very less, 0.5 volts per microseconds. I hope the summary is clear. Gain is infinity, input resistance is infinity, output resistance is zero, bandwidth is infinity, CMRR is infinity, slew rate is infinity. So this is a summary of ideal op amp and practical op amp. I hope the class is clear. In this class, we have learned how to define the characteristics of op amp, their symbolic notations, definitions, characteristics of ideal op amp, and then finally the summary of ideal op amp values and practical op amp values. Thank you for watching. If you have any queries, post in the comment section. Good luck, students.